Hello students, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here I am covering the concepts of binary tree data structure. From the binary tree data structure, in this video series, I am explaining you the threaded binary tree. So before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the introduction to the threaded binary tree, the first video of this video series. Before moving to the threaded binary tree, let's think about what is a binary tree. So a binary tree, name itself suggests that it has at most two children or two child nodes, and whenever we want to represent a binary tree, we are going to represent in a given manner. So this one is your root node and it is having both the child nodes. This one is the left child and this one is the right child. So now here you can see that few of the fields are null. Null indicates that it is a, if both the left and right pointer of any of the node are null, then it indicates that they are the leaf nodes. So with respect to the leaf nodes, here you can see that four times the null is represented, and now we have to think about that null pointer into the threaded binary tree. So what is threaded binary tree? So the link part in the node representation remains null. There are two cases where the link part remains null. So for a node which is having only one child, so if no child is there, either left or right, that part is going to become null, and the node who is having no child node, that is a leaf node. So in case of leaf node, both the pointers are becoming the null. So in this case, what we have to do, we have to form the threads. So this is the situation where if both the pointers are null, say a left pointer is null and a right pointer is null for node B, as it is a leaf node, and the same thing for C node, both the left and right child are null. It indicates that the null is represented in any of the node, it indicates that there is no child is present for that node. So what is the threaded binary tree? So in the threaded binary tree, what we have to do, we have to replace all the null values by the threads. So threaded binary tree, it reuses the empty or a null links or a pointer by making some threads. So here for your reference, I am providing you the same diagram where A was a root node, its left child was B and its right child was C, so that the null pointer are replaced with the threads. Always threads are represented by the dotted arrow, and always threads are growing from the lower level to the higher level or from the child node to the parent node. So here this is only the representation, this is not the full concept of the threaded binary tree that I am going to explain you very soon in this video series. So I would like to request you to stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Now let's see what are the advantages of the threaded binary tree. So let's see the first advantage. It reutilizes the empty or the null links by making some threads. So threads are reused, threads are reusing the null pointer or the empty space. Though they are holding the null, or if they are empty, still we are using the memory space for the allocation for the whole node. So that memory wastage is reused by the threads in the threaded binary tree is the first advantage. Second advantage is the threads are very helpful for the traversal of the tree. because threads helps us to traverse the tree in a linear way, and hence the traversal is going to become very fast and with very less efforts. So this mainly the threads are helpful for the traversal of the tree with less efforts. And the third advantage is, as all of us are knowing, whenever we want to traverse a binary tree that may be recursive or non-recursive, we supposed to take the help of stack data structure. But this threaded binary tree is going to traverse the tree without help of any extra data structure like stack. So this is your third advantage. Now let's move forward to see the disadvantage of the threaded binary tree. So in the disadvantage of the threaded binary tree, let's see. The first disadvantage is, to reuse the empty or null links, we have to maintain some extra memory field to indicate that whether whatever we are replacing with null are threads, or that the field that the left pointer and right pointer are holding the address of its left child and the right child. So these things you will come to know very soon when I'll explain you the structure of the threaded binary tree or the node of threaded binary tree. Right now just keep in mind that here in threaded binary tree we have to maintain some extra memory whenever we are going to reutilize these empty or null fields. And in the same way, to perform the insertion and the deletion operation, or to write down the algorithm, to implement the algorithm for the insertion and deletion operation, they are somehow more difficult than that of the regular threaded binary tree, as it has to maintain the threads. So while performing insertion and deletion operation, we are supposed to take care of the threads, which extra task we have to perform, hence they are going to become difficult. And the last disadvantage is, inclusively, that's why to maintain the extra memory, they are going to become more difficult to maintain the threads. Inclusively, it is going to become very complicated as far as the implementation of the threaded binary tree is concerned. So by considering all these things, we will continue with in details of the threaded binary tree, its representation, its types, its structure and operations, how they are going to perform on a threaded binary tree in the next coming videos. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and share this video with your friends. Thank you.